For as long as games have existed, so have cheats. But I'm not talking about the Konami Code, nor entering God Mode in Ratchet & Clank. Today we're going to be discussing online cheats in multiplayer games, from aimbot to wall hacks, ESP, and adjusting hitboxes. How they work in general, how are they being stopped with anti-cheat software, and what a little company that you may have heard of called Riot Games is doing to prevent it. But before we jump into it, if you're new here, you already know the drill. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button, ding the bell to get notified for all your game dev needs, like the video, and watch the whole thing. Cheating online nowadays is being done through editing software, injecting code right into the game scripts, and forging network traffic. By doing all these things, gamers have been able to raise their KD, get perfect scores, and even beat the best of players. It's probably even happened to you, several times I assume. Playing a game where you get killed by someone who could have never seen you, or maybe was able to aim and lock on to you instantly. So in order to stop cheaters like these, developers have been making anti-cheat software that's required to be installed and running while playing the game, such as Valve Anti-Cheat, Punk Buster, BattleEye, and Epic Anti-Cheat. Putting it simply, software like these have anywhere from dozens to hundreds of checks to make sure that you aren't cheating, that they can check the player's computer memory for matching signatures existing in the database, and if they don't belong to the game, they can detect the cheat. They can also scan for their software, looking for blacklisted code or any sort of change or tampering in the game's scripts. On top of that, developers constantly send in updates, forcing any edited files to be reverted to the original and up-to-date game. Since League of Legends' initial release, Riot Games has had to deal with thousands of cheating players, so in order to prevent them in their newest game, Valorant, they decided to take a step back and change some things. When it comes to anti-cheat software, their development focuses on three phases: deterrence, prevention, and detection. Doing so, they are in a constant cycle, looking for cheaters, stopping them, and preventing new ones. If the player's game state, such as coordinates, health, etc., doesn't need to be shared, they don't share it. Their servers make all the actual game decisions, from hitboxes and how much damage is dealt to the player's life and keeping track of scores. And all of this occurs in their proper servers, with set network protocols allowing much of the data to be hidden and encrypted. And all of these steps have been put into action with Riot Games' newest game, Valorant, with the beta just being opened around a week ago using their newest anti-cheat software known as Vanguard, and within even 2 days, the beta being opened, a cheater had already been through, but Riot's Vanguard was able to catch them, and now he's been banned. So Vanguard seems to be doing well, but only time will tell. It's also been causing quite a buzz and a stir across Reddit and the internet as a whole. When you install Valorant, you are forced to install Vanguard and reboot your computer as well. It's normal for anti-cheat software to run while the game is open, but players fully discovering that the Vanguard system file is ran at boot from the kernel level, giving it the highest level of privilege known as Ring Zero. It scans through the whole machine, making sure that nothing is not out of the ordinary. Since the discovery, many people have complained, and the head of Vanguard even replied, saying even though the software runs at boot, it doesn't collect nor send any data, and the actual anti-cheat itself is only constantly running when the game is. But what makes some players upset is the lack of disclosure, the possibility that in the future it can be used for other things, in the fact that if a bug happens to be sent through in the Vanguard update, it could do more than just stop the anti-cheat in the game from working. It could stop your computer from even starting up. One Redditor even points out that you can change the file name and then it won't run. And when you want to play the game, go ahead and revert the file name back and reboot your computer and it'll work. But this is a large hassle. To me, even though the software runs from the kernel level, it doesn't seem to do that much of a harm. And it works just like any other anti-cheat software, and so far seems to be doing the job. But I would love to hear what you guys have to say about Vanguard and even the new Valorant game. Leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments section below. Don't forget to like the video, it helps me make more content just like this. And if you're new to the channel, check it out. I have some similar videos to this and some game programming tutorials. We started off a month of April with 400-ish subs, and our goal is to reach 500 by the end of the month. And so far we are doing great. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope that everyone is safe at home and you guys enjoy the video. And just remember that maybe, just maybe, next time you die, you can't blame it on an aimbot. See you guys next time.